Thank you. This is Jason, and we have an interesting news for you today. Our scientists still don't know what caused the end of the world in 1979, but some researchers in Hungary had some interesting findings. They say their new experiments show that there is another timeline, and supposedly that one is the normal one, and we are living in a so-called derailed, not normal timeline. Basically, they say that something in 1979 caused the main timeline to split into two different parts. The other one went into a normal direction, into the future or something, and this one, well, this one got screwed up and is stuck, basically. We cannot really do anything about this, they think, but hopefully someday we can communicate somehow with the people from the normal timeline. Now that would be interesting, right? They also said that we must be sometimes in 1988 or something, but because the flow of this time is also screwed up, they are not certain about this date. Some other news. More and more scientists are concerned that the bacon you can find in abandoned buildings is actually not good for your health. Contrary to what the Hungarian Pig Apocalypse Bacon Factory says, of course, they keep saying that their food is the healthiest food you can find in these hard times, but people said they gotten hairy after eating it, and we had a caller who said that his mom began to make pig noises after eating two big slices of this particular brand of bacon. Then again, we should be happy that this factory still produces us something to eat. Have a day. Chat till you die news. Today a man has been reported of chatting till he died. How sad, man. Although, I like it. I like it pretty much. I mean, I do not like the fact that the guy died. I like the fact that he died because of chatting, you know? I love chatting, man. I love it too, I must say. And he did it till he died. He died what he loved best, my man. He died doing what he loved best, my man. And I think he was smart. They say he was smart. I think you can find his grave somewhere. You know, good man, good chatter. He died a good death. He had a good talk. He chatted till he died. Chat till you die. FM 95. Chat till you die. Go and eat some pie or get really high. While you are listening to Chat Till You Die. Hello everyone, this is Jason again, and I must say, I have the best job in the whole wide world. I'm just having fun and talking, and I'm basically chatting with you guys, even if I don't hear your responses. You know what would be fun? Playing games, like board games or some computer games, and having tons of people just look at it. Seriously, if I could do that, that would be so amazing. But nah, it is just a fantasy. There never will be a thing like that. But in my fantasy, in my world, there is. Chat till you die. If you wanna know why, raise your head up high. Like, imagine you could get paid doing this. Like, playing video games for money, for fame. Wouldn't that be nice? Chat till you die. You like to listen to Jason, don't you lie? Oh, you are little assholes, and shit is flowing out of them constantly. And those parents, dear God, they always said we would overpopulate and all that, and they always say there are way too many people on the earth, but still they produce tons of these tiny assholes. Because hey, they said, I want kids, but other people should not have any, because then there will be too many. I just don't get it, my man, I just don't get it. As for me, I like the way things are now. Please, people, keep killing each other. This is the best birth control that was ever invented. Way better than condoms or pills. Angry Greg, he runs you over with a Cadillac. What the beep is wrong with people? How can you confuse an Italian sausage with a Hungarian one? It's like confusing your mother with your sister. Wait, that happened to me once. Not that I did anything wrong with them, I mean, I was just hungry, okay? Get off my back. Was it my girlfriend? I don't know, man. They taste all the same when you cook them right. That said, can you be vegan in the apocalypse? Like, you cannot really grow.
Heute ist es sehr heiß, heißer als in einem Ofen, das in Deutschland gab.
Nice.
You are going to die by my hand. You little green bastards keep staring at me. Shut up, I swear I can hear them talk. I just hate them. Hypocrites. My God, where do I even start with these bastards? And what always bugs my mind, do hypocrites know they are? Did ever just one of them admit it to being one? Well, that goes for all the other things too, you know, stuff like when you say he's an idiot, and when you say, hey, George is a dumb guy. Does George know he is a dumb guy? Did ever just one person on earth acknowledge or admit that he's one of the above mentioned? I think not. But this is...
Übermensch Radio, wir sind die Helden. So guten Tag allerseits, ich bin so froh, dass ihr unser Radio anhört.
Coming in stores near you.
This is Boom Chill Radio on 100.5. This is a real nice coffee. We here at Boom Chill Radio use the magnificent coffee brand, the Sea Keef Cafe. It is the most tasty coffee ever. Especially tasty if you are reading a nice book, you know, reading poems, making love to your rubber wife or your wooden wife if you are old-fashioned like me. Talking about old-fashioned, we have lots and lots of old poems we can read for you because these have no copyright protection on them. So if you are home with your wife, be it rubber, wood, or a real one if you are the luckiest man on earth, or if you are driving in a post-apocalyptic desert in your Chola, your Tarbans, or Faltenberger, just sit back, relax, grab a cup of feces, Sea Keef Cafe, and join us. For Annie by Edgar Allan Poe.
Thank heaven, the crisis, the danger is past, and the lingering illness is over at last, and the fever called living is conquered at last. Sadly, I know I am shorn of my strength, and no muscle I move as I lie at full length. But no matter, I feel I am better at length. And I rest so composedly now in my bed, that any beholder might fancy me dead, might start at beholding me, thinking me dead. The moaning and groaning and sighing and sobbing